This picture could be painted 1,000 times. This story could be told 1,000 times. It was told to me before I got in it.
Yeah,
you know,
way to go.
It was explained to me. I've heard people talk about it and tell it. And all I can tell you from seeing both sides is that there's nothing that can prepare you for this roller coaster. Nothing.
G.
My name is Gerald. My name is G-Eazy. I am Gerald in this film. I am G-Eazy in this film. So this crazy guy named Bob, he comes over and I'm finishing up the album. I had played him a lot of it. And he says, I got it. Let's do a short film and tie in these songs and how they play thematically into the concept of the album. And, you know, tie it all together in kind of like a short film, long form music video, and put that out with the album.
G and I have worked on every piece of album art that he's put out in the last 6 or 7 years. And this started out with us wondering what the album art was gonna be. So he drove into the desert with his sweet Mustang and we shot photos. And once we got back and started editing them down, they looked and felt like film stills.
You know, the fact that two people I trust, you know, the most when it comes to my Jedi Council, when two people come to me with very similar ideas, you know, a day apart, unknowingly, that's the universe talking to me. A big part of the concept of the album was internal duality between Gerald and G-Eazy, but also that external duality of success and fame and how the highs can be really high, but the lows and the pitfalls and the dark side of some of this can be really, really low and really dark. And, you know, from, you know, the pressure, the extent of the schedule, the, you know, cutting yourself open and pouring your heart out on these records and being vulnerable as an artist and putting it all out there and giving so much of you, of yourself, you know, to this public thing that is then looked at and picked apart and critiqued and talked about and loved or is hated on. Your duty as an artist is to really put yourself out there.
Question about performing, you know?
I think they need you for like in 10 minutes, I think they said. 8:20 or something.
That's 7 minutes.
Get some more rest.
People don't understand the workload. People don't understand the pressure. People don't understand the distractions. People don't understand the pitfalls. Like, you can get it, but until you're walking through those like treacherous steps yourself and you're seeing it firsthand, you can't get it.
Hey man, another day in the coal mine. Day one of the short film shoots.
Oh my God,
exhausted. A whole lot of hurry up and wait. What you just see?
I see some butt cheeks. That's what makes me move. I breathe.
It's a short film, but it's still a video.
The title is borrowed from the book, and it's about the 1920s. I'm in my 20s. I think there's a parallel to the lifestyle that I live in today's world and my part in it, being a rapper, living how I live, to how people were living in the 1920s. They were drinking all the time. They were, you know, going out, and they eventually, you know, they woke up. And in the 30s, it was the Great Depression, and no one knew that was coming, you know? So there was this dark ending to this, like, out of control lifestyle that they were living. And, you know, little did they know that that lifestyle wasn't sustainable. This is what I spent my life learning how to do. Making music, expressing myself in this way, but there's that nakedness that comes with it, that vulnerability that never gets, you know, you're never invincible. No matter if you can put on your cloak and you can act like it or you can look like it, you know, like, I'm still sensitive about my shit, you know, like everyone else.
None of this shit is real. None of this bullshit around you that you're so obsessed with. None of these people around you cling to you. Just stroke your fucking ego and make you feel cool.
There is these two people who are generally at odds with each other, and they are, you know, they're both G-Eazy, they're both Gerald, they're both my friend. I know both of them, and they're not always friendly with each other. And that's kind of like that was like the general conflict of the whole thing.
With the short, I really wanted to like express that duality in terms of Gerald, in terms of G-Eazy, in terms of maintaining yourself, your integrity, staying a good person, remembering why you started in the first place, why you fell in love with it, you know, the people that helped you get there, but then also showing the other side, the G-Eazy, the rock star, the distractions, the fast life, you know, and you know, how you see a lot of people get lost in the sauce, how you see people get caught up in the hype or caught up in the fame or, you know, get attracted to it for the wrong reasons or the wrong things. And, you know, these kind of things that pull you in different directions. That sex, drugs, and rock and roll thing is real. Thought that was always the plan. Thought that was always the plan. Did it, I do it
again. You know, thought that was always the plan. It's like the idea is like when Gerald first gets out of the trunk, he's like, fuck this, I'm getting the fuck out of here. He goes down the road, he's like, wait a minute. That motherfucker tried to kill me.
Yeah.
Gets back in the car, comes back, and then right as he's like about to, he flips his headlights on.